This is a Jivamukti open class, and we don't have props, which will be fine without them, so I'll make it easy for that. As you take a seat, you still have to roll the inner thighs back and apart, maybe putting one heel in front of the other. Doing your best to really feel the sit bones pushing down, push down to extend up and create space through the side body, and taking just a moment to come into the breathing, inhaling and exhaling through your nose. Allow the breath to move in as you inhale. And as you exhale, feeling the warmth of the air exhaling out through the nostrils. On every inhalation, try to take it through the nose, allowing the breath to come in. And as you exhale, exhaling out. Bring your chins parallel with the floor. Take the throat and your ears back. As you take the throat, ears back, you'll be stacking the head in line with the spine. Keep pushing down through your seat to create space. Allow the shoulders to relax away from your ears. We'll begin to move your breath into three parts on inhalation and three parts on exhalation. See if you can stay with me. Exhaling all of the breath out. Your next inhalation through the nose, feel your belly rise. Feel it moving up into your ribcage and then up into your chest. As you exhale, start with the chest. Feel the ribs knitting closer together, drawing the navel in toward the spine to exhale it all out. Inhaling, feeling the belly rise. Feel the ribs expand, chest lifting. Exhaling. Chest, ribs, and belly. Continuing just like that, fully inhaling, feeling the abdomen rise, the ribs expand, chest lift. Exhaling, chest, ribs, and belly. We'll bring our hands into the heart center, and as you press the palms against one another, feel the heart really lifting. Take a deep inhale through your nose, open the mouth, and sigh, exhale, send it out. Do that two more times. Inhaling deeply, open your mouth, sigh, exhale, let it go. One more time. Inhaling, open your mouth, sigh it out, leave it all behind. Our next one will be our own. Inhaling. Sahana Vavatu, Sahana Bunaktu, Sahavivyam Karvavahai, Tejasvina Varitamastu, Mavivishavahai. Bow your head to your heart center. Take a moment to set your own intention for this practice today. In the opening invocation, I've asked that we come together, we practice together, we learn together, we grow together, and may you harbor no ill feelings for me for this. And as you bow your head to the heart center, releasing your hands onto your thighs, lifting your chin, slowly open your eyes and come onto hands and knees. Hands and knees, come there. From hands and knees, a little bit of cat-cow, so inhale. Chest seat up, we're all doing spine. And as you exhale, the head comes in, pelvis comes in, push around and squeeze it out. Again, inhaling, lifting the head, chest seat up. Exhale, head comes in, pelvis comes in, press around and squeeze. Inhaling your spine into a neutral position, big toes together, knees apart, sit back onto your heels, bow down in the center, taking a child's pose. So in child's pose, you're just taking a moment here to really feel yourself grounding. Feel your hands pressing into the floor. Pull the floor back. Come to hands and knees. Curl the toes under. Lift your bottom up and push your chest back to your thighs. Down dog. In down dog, taking a moment here to shake your head yes and no. Cycling through the legs. Bending one knee. Working opposite heel down. Inhaling and exhaling.
And just letting yourself coming into this practice, really feeling grounded, making it your very own practice. After a few cycles of the legs, stay in your down dog, go up onto the balls of your feet, push your chest really close to the thighs, get your sit bones way up in the air. Take a deep inhale, and as you exhale, stretch your heels down toward the floor. Inhaling to plank pose, top of a push-up. Exhaling through chaturanga down to the floor. So slow, all the way down to the floor. From the floor, bring the pelvis, lift your head and chest. Shoulder lift, throw it back, ears back. Exhale, seat to the heels, extend your legs fully down dog. Inhaling plank, top of a push-up. Exhale, listen carefully, knees, chest, and chin, elbows in tight. Press your hands down, pull the floor back, sliding forward, you feel in the back of the arms, cobra. Exhale, seat to the heels, extend your legs fully down dog. And last but not least, inhaling to plank pose. Make sure you're shifting a little forward as you go to full chaturanga, elbows in line with the shoulders. Inhaling into upward facing dog, shoulder blades sliding down the back, heart through, legs back. Exhaling down dog. Okay, those are some of your options. Slowly walking your feet up to your hands. Have the feet about hip bone distance apart. Put a little bend in your knees. Extend your arms out to the sides. Flip your palms up. Clasping the hands behind your back. As you press your palms into each other, push your feet down, lift your sit bones up, and the arms coming over. Inhaling and exhaling here. Just hang out and let the blood rush to your brain and breathe, exhaling everything. This is very calming for the nervous system. This is also a shoulder opener, so shake your head yes and shake your head no to really let it go. Releasing your arms, let them dangle free. Press through your feet and gently begin to round and roll up slowly all the way up to the top. As you come up to the top of the mat, we'll set up for sun salutation, Surya Namaskar. Turn up on me. Everything's resisting me today. All right. So these are Jivamukti sun salutations, a little different. Pass your thumbs, pull them apart, reach fingertips away. As you pull the thumbs apart, reach your fingertips away, push your feet down and inhale the arms all the way up. Looking back as you exhale, bend your knees, swing your arms up and over, clasp your hands, palms together, and straighten the legs. Hands onto the floor, each side of the feet, right foot steps back, lunge. So look forward, shoulder blades down your back. Exhale, step it back, down dog, push it back. Inhale, plank, top of a push-up. Exhale, chaturanga. Inhaling into upward facing dog. Good, back bend there. Exhale, down dog. Inhale, plank. Exhale, knees, chest, and chin to the floor. Inhale, slowly into cobra, feel the back of your arms. Exhale, seat to the heels, extend your legs fully down dog. Inhaling, right foot steps up between your hands. Exhaling, left foot to follow. With a big bend in your knees, clasp the thumbs, reaching the arms out. Up, go, back, back, back. And then do it again. Exhale, fold forward, swing your arms up and over, clasp your hands, straighten legs. Hands onto the floor, each side of your feet. Left foot steps back, lunge. Exhale, right foot back, down dog, push it back. Inhale, plank. Exhale, chaturanga, any variation. Inhaling into the upward facing dog. Exhaling, downward facing dog. Inhale, plank, connecting your breath. Exhaling, knees, chest, and chin with the arch in the back. Inhaling slowly into cobra, anchoring through the pelvis. Curl your toes, seat to the heels, extend your legs fully down dog. Inhaling, left foot steps out between your hands, knee over your heel or ankle. Exhaling, right foot to follow. With a big bend in the knees, clasping the thumbs, reaching the arms out. Up, go, back, back, back. And hands into heart center, top of the mat, and breathe. That's one. Here we go, keeping your breath constant. Inhaling, reaching the arms out. Up, back, back, back. Exhale, fold forward. Swing your arms up and over, clasping your hands, straighten legs more.
Hands onto the floor, each side of your feet. Right foot steps back, lunge. Exhale, left foot back, down dog. Make it a good exhale. Inhale, plank. Exhale, chaturanga strong. Inhaling into upward facing dog, reach your legs away, bring your heart forward. Exhaling, down dog. Inhale, plank, full breath. Exhale, knees, chest, and chin, arching in the back. Inhale, slowly into cobra, feel the anchor of the pelvis. Exhale, seat to the heels, extend your legs fully down dog. Are you breathing? Inhaling, right foot steps up between your hands. Exhaling, left foot to follow. With a big bend in the knees, clasping thumbs, reaching the arms out, up, going back even further this time. And then exhale, full force, swinging your arms up and over, cast your hands straight legs. Hands onto the floor, each side of your feet. Left foot steps back, lunge. So look forward, shoulder blades down your back. Exhale, push it back, down dog. Give it a good exhale all the way up. Next inhale, plank pose, top of the push-up. Exhale, chaturanga, elbows in tight. Inhaling into upward facing dog, curl up into the back. Exhaling, down dog. Inhale, plank. Exhale, knees, chest, and chin, arching your back. Inhale slowly into cobra. So everybody in cobra, take your hands up off the floor. Push your pelvis down, push your toenails down. Roll your shoulder blades down your back. Take your throat back, ears back, and feel the heart lift. Exhale, seat to the heels, extend your legs fully. Down dog. Inhaling, left foot steps up between your hands, near your heel or ankle. Exhale, right foot to follow. With a big bend in the knees, passing the thumbs, reaching the arms out. Up, going back, back, back. And hands in to heart center. There's going to be a few add-ons here. Top of the mat. Clasp your thumbs, reaching the arms out. Up, go back, back, back. Exhale, fold forward. Swing your arms up and over. Clasp your hands straight legs. Hands onto the floor, each side of your feet. Right foot steps back, lunge. So holding the lunge, come up to teacup fingers, shoulder blades down your back. Without bringing your right knee forward, take it down and back toward the floor. Lift your left toes. Now, if it's tender for your knee, you can fold the right side of the mat for your knee. Left toes lift, push your foot down, drag it back, and bring your left knee in front of your left toes. You're going to feel this on the right side a whole lot. Be sure to power through your legs. The front foot's pulling back, the back knee's pulling forward, and you feel the inner thighs engage, outer hips engage, taking your arms up alongside of the ears. That's it. So feel that deep stretch on the right front hip of your body. Gazing up, inhale, and as you exhale, hands come down. Step back, down dog. Push it back. I know. Inhale, plank. That's why I have the song moaning for you. Exhale, chaturanga. Inhaling into upward facing dog. I knew. And then exhale, down your facing dog. Good. Inhale, plank. Exhale, knees, chest, and chin, elbows in tight. Now really feel this. Push your hands down, pull the floor back, and go really slow like a little snake. Your back of your arms should be burning like it never had before. Shoulder blades onto your back, push your feet into the floor. Hands up, make the muscles along the spine. Hands underneath the shoulders, curl the toes, push the seat to your heels, and extend your legs fully for down dog. Here you go, Gabby, it's coming for you. Right foot steps up between your hands and your heel or ankle. Teacup fingers, shoulder blades down your back. Keep your hips low to start. Then, placing your left knee down, reach it way back. So lift your right toes, push the foot down, try to pull the foot back as you bring your right knee forward, and you'll go to the meaty part above your left knee. Keeping that kind of action, the legs squeezing, hugging and squeezing. Here we go, arms up. So the left side, front of our hips, that's where we hold a lot of anxiety in there. That's our fight or flight muscle group, right? Exhaling, hands down, step your left foot forward, meet the right. Put a big bend in your knees. Don't be in a hurry to go anywhere. Here we go. Sit low, thighs parallel, extend your arms out. Clasping the thumbs, pull them apart, reaching your arms out. Up, go back, back, back. And then do it again. Exhale, pull forward. Swing your arms up and over, cross your hands, straight legs. Hands onto the floor at each side of your feet. Left foot steps back, lunge. Shoulder blades down your back, teacup fingers. Then placing the left knee down to the floor. Keep your fingertips on the floor. Pull the floor back as you bring your right knee forward, going down a little closer. So the hips are low, they will stay. That's where they are. Clasp the thumbs, reach fingertips away. Pull the belly off the thighs, reach out if that's something you want there, that's it. Keep your hips low. The higher your arms go, the lower your hips go. Take it back, back, back. Oh, so nice. Exhaling, hands down, step it back down dog. Woo! Inhale, plank. Exhale, chaturanga. Press it back up, plank. Just checking out, it hurts. Chaturanga, yeah, Christine, you got it. Chaturanga. Push it back up, plank. Those are push-ups. You're just checking your breath. And chaturanga into upward facing dog. Woo! And exhale, downward facing dog. Inhaling, plank. Exhaling, knees, chest, and chin. Feel the arch in your back. Push your hands down, pull the floor back, let it work the back of your arms, shoulder blades down your back, pelvis anchors, that's it. Exhaling, sink to the heels, extend your legs fully down dog. Inhaling, left foot steps up between your hands, knee over your hip or ankle. Here we go. Teacup fingers, lower the hips, placing your right knee down to the floor. But with your fingertips, push down, pull the floor back, and bring your left knee in front. So now we're on the meaty part above our right knee. Keeping this action, pull the belly off the thighs, extend your arms out. Clasping your thumbs, pull them apart, broadening your chest through this action. Reach out, out, out. Hips stay this low, they don't go higher. Here we go. Arms up, hips low. Arms up, hips low. Feel that deep stretch. And then as you exhale, the hands down. Step your right foot forward and meet the left. We're all sitting into our chairs. Here we go. Palms down. Shoulders over your hips. Tailbones down. Clasp your thumbs. Reach your arms out. Push through your heels. Up, back, back, back. And hands into heart center. Top of the mat and breathe. Surya Namaskar B. Feet close together. Top of the mat. Inhaling, Utkatasana chair pose. Sit low, arms high. Good. Exhale, fold forward all the way down. Inhale, half lift. Exhaling, chaturanga, low push up. Inhaling into upward facing dog. Exhaling, downward facing dog. Inhale, right foot steps forward, pivoting left. Here, Virabhadrasana 1. Step heavy into your back foot. Arms up. Warrior 1. Exhaling, hands touch down. Stepping back. Chaturanga slow. 5, 4, and 3. Elbows in line with the shoulders. Here we go. Inhaling into upward facing dog. Curling through your back. Exhaling, downward facing dog. Inhaling, left foot steps forward. Pivot right. Step heavy into the right foot as you bring it up. Here, Virabhadrasana 1. Warrior 1. That's it. Gaze up between your hands as you inhale. Exhale, hands down, step back, chaturanga slow. 5, 4, 3. Inhaling into upward facing dog. Curl through your upper spine. Exhaling, downward facing dog. Inhaling, right foot steps forward. Pivot left, Virabhadrasana 1. Step heavy in your feet, arms up and hold. Inhaling, exhaling, 1. Inhaling, exhaling, 2. The right foot is pushing down, it's dragging back, so the right hip pulls back, left hip comes forward, inner thighs zipping up, heart opening. Inhale, and as you exhale, open out to your left, Virabhadrasana 2, warrior 2. Inhale, straighten your front leg. As you exhale, right arm reaches way out over the right leg, so stretch it out, side by long. Stretch, 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 keep the activity of your legs. Right fingertips down to the floor or a shin. Sweep your left arm up and stack it over the right. Inhale, exhaling, 1. Inhaling, exhaling, 2. Inhaling, exhaling, 3. Inhaling, exhaling, 4. Inhaling, exhaling, 5. Push down through your feet, inhaling all the way up to the top.
Exhale, bending your right knee over the pillar ankle, warrior two. So tailbone's down, low belly draws in and up, extending your arms out, shoulder blades over your back, gaze out over your right little finger. Inhaling and exhaling for four. Inhaling, exhaling, five. Inhale, straighten your front leg. Here we go, combo platter. Exhale, bending the right knee, reaching your right arm out. So side body long, really drive the left heel down. Right forearm can go onto the thigh, palm facing up, or the right hand can go down to the floor outside of your right foot. Sweeping your left arm up, stack it over the right, broaden through your chest, and if it's available, left arm alongside of the left ear, palm facing on, ankle pinky down. Now drive your left foot down to bring your chest forward, spin the right side of your belly and chest open to the ceiling. Inhaling and exhaling for three. Inhaling, exhaling, four. Are you breathing? Inhaling, exhaling, the left hand comes down. So framing your front foot, step your left foot in just a little bit. Pivot the left foot so you're stepping heavy into the outer blade of your left foot. Lift your right toes, push your right foot down, and lift your right kneecap up. Tap your right hip back, turn your left hip down, and imagine the tightest pair of jeans you've ever worn. Zip up your inner thighs. As you exhale, chin to shin, one. Inhaling, exhaling, two. Inhaling, exhaling, three. And I want to get to it. Four. Inhaling, exhaling, five. Inhale, lifting your head and chest. As you exhale, bend your front knee, step it back, down dog. Ha, go ahead, breathe. If you haven't started, go ahead. Inhale, left foot steps up, pivot right, mirror crossing one. Step, anchor your feet down, lift your heart up, arms up, shoulder blades in the back. Feel the power in this pose. This is the warrior that slays the demon and places its head on the stick, right? The demon being our ego. Inhaling and exhaling, four. Inhaling, exhaling, five. Inhale, spin open to your right, warrior two. This is the warrior that chops off the head of the ego, right? So get down low, be powerful in your legs. Push down and lift up. Wrists away from your hips, gaze out over the left middle finger. Steady in your breath. Inhale, straighten your front legs. As you exhale, reach the left arm out. Stretch it, palm down, reach. Come get it. Shift your hip a little bit more. Good, keep that left hand down. Right arm up. Inhale, exhale, one. So triangle pose, you can go down to the shin or the floor or wherever it goes, but keep the side body long, inhaling and exhaling. That's it, so staying with your breath. That's it. Inhale and exhale, I got to touch you again. You guys are so perfect. Breathe in, exhaling it out. Inhaling and exhale. Do you feel the power in your legs? You're really engaging the muscles. Push down through your feet. Inhale, bring yourself all the way up to the top, shoulders over your hips. Exhale, bending your left knee over the pillar ankle. Remember, pelvic tilt, tailbone down, shoulders stay over your hips, power through your legs. Inhale, straightening your front leg. As you exhale, bend your left knee. Here we go, combo platter. Plow with your right foot and reach the left arm out. Strong in your legs. Forearm goes onto the thigh, palm facing up, or the fingertips go to the floor outside of your left foot. Releasing your right arm in line with your right shoulder, sweeping it up, stack it over the left, and if it's available, right arm alongside the right ear. Palm face down, ankle pinky down. That's it. You guys got it. Push with your back foot. As you push with your back foot, spin the left side of your belly and chest open. Reach up through your fingertips. Feel the whole side body giving breath into that space. Inhaling the right hand. Comes down, we're framing the front foot with both hands. Step your right foot up as much as you need to and out to the right. Put teacup fingers down to the floor. Lift your left toes. Press your left foot down as you straighten the left leg up and pull it back. Right hip turns down toward the floor. Zip up your inner thighs. Inhale, and as you exhale, folding forward, chin to shin, one. Inhaling, exhaling. Two, inhaling, exhaling, three, inhaling, exhaling, four, inhaling,
Inhale, lifting your head and chest. Exhale, bending your front knees, stepping back, down dog. Inhaling and exhaling here. Just shake your head yes, shake your head no. Fill the space that you made in the body. At the end of your next exhalation, bend your knees deeply. Now don't do anything with it yet. Don't do anything with it. Get your bottoms way up in the air. Bend your knees a lot. Push your hands down. And you're going to kick your own butt for 10. Go ahead. Give it a kick. By pushing down, you can lift up. Feel your hands connected down. Move your hands down. That's it. Catch a little air. You might catch a little air. It's cool. That's it. Just feel yourself feeling it great time. That's it. And after your 10th one, you'll jump your feet up. Good. Yes, Abby. There it is. And then get your feet up to your hands. Nice. Beautiful. Inhaling, half lift. That was sneaky, wasn't it? Exhale, forward fold. Inhaling, Uttanasana chair pose, arms up. Exhaling, coming up to the top. Namaste. Perfect. So from the top of the mat, with our right foot, you can step your right leg out to the right. Open the legs up wide. And in fact, just check, extend your arms out to the sides and make sure that your ankles are underneath your own wrist. That's how wide your stance should be. Yeah, slightly pigeon toe your feet in. So the toes angle in, the heels out just a bit. Place your hands onto your hips for now. Now lift the right ball of your foot and pivot on your heel to turn the foot out 90 degrees. But keep your left hip pulling back so your hips and shoulders, you guys are squaring off to this, and your hips and shoulders to that wall. Now, inhaling the arms out, bend your right knee. You're on a date with your own right kneecap. Where is it going? Your knees go toward the second and third toe. The back leg is straight, shoulders over your hips. As you inhale, reach the right arm way out over your right leg. Place the right hand down to the floor inside of your right foot. Sweep your left arm up and stack it over the right. So wrist over wrist. That's it. Now here, try to broaden your chest. So lean back, the back leg and back. Push your knee against the arm resists. Press your pelvis forward. That's it. Lengthening your spine. Breathe. Get a breath in there. Inhaling and exhaling. Now, drive your left foot down. Use your left arm and bring yourself all the way up to standing. Inhale. Right toes turn forward. Hands to the hips. Left foot turns out 90 degrees. Okay. Remember, the hip, this is a hip opener, but it's the kneecap that's going to try to come into the middle. So lift your toes. Engage the muscle to the bone. Here we go. Bend the left knee over your heel or ankle. Look at your own kneecap. Can it go toward the second and third toe? But bring the pelvis forward. Tailbone's down. The belly draws in and up. And the back leg is super straight. Inhale. As you exhale, reach the left arm. Pushing with the right foot to get this. You can place the left hand down to the floor inside of the left foot. Releasing your right arm down. Palm facing in. Keep your legs powered and sweep your right arm up. Now we should be broadening the chest. So as you push your knee against the arm resists, and that's the lever to get the deep twist in there. Feel yourself, push your back foot down and take your heart forward. Broaden through your chest, finding your breath. Now really drive your right heel down, use your right heel and your right leg. Come on all the way up. Hands to your hips, left toes turn forward. Here we go, right foot turns out again. Now you're going to have an opportunity for a bind. If you are not a binder, I'll talk you through it. If you're a binder, you go full bind. I'm not going to talk you to bind, okay? Right foot turns out. You'll see what I mean. Inhale, as you exhale, bend the right knee, reaching the right arm out. Start with the right hand down inside of the right foot. Let's release the left arm, palm facing in, and sweep the left arm up. Okay. Take your left hand, turn the palm facing back. Bend the left elbow and reach for your right inner thigh. Now, as you pull onto the right inner thigh, your left shoulder blade, you have to do like you're doing some sort of glam, sexy shot. Left shoulder blade onto the back. Get down lower into your hips. Push your right elbow against the right calf. Those two resist and keep spinning the belly and chest open. You should feel that revolve, inhaling and exhaling. Then releasing the bind, left arm back up to the ceiling. Press your left foot down, straightening your right leg, hands to the hips, right toes turn in, left foot turns out 90 degrees. I know, don't think about it, just gotta breathe. In and out, and as you exhale, left knee bends, left hand comes down at first. When you release your right arm, release it in line with your own shoulder, palm facing in, and then sweep it up first in your right hand. Then turn the right hand back, bend at the elbow, and then still keep the clearance in your shoulder to reach for the left inner thigh. Then go lower into your hips, then be real sexy with the right shoulder, roll the right shoulder blade onto the back, push through your feet, really extend, press your pelvis forward as you spin open. Take the chin out of your chest, breathing into that, inhaling and exhaling. Then, inhaling, unwrapping your right arm, reach it up to the ceiling. Use your right leg and straighten your left leg up. Hands to your hips, turn left toes forward. Hugging your inner elbows in toward one another. You're going to make good friends right now, so be careful. I may stagger a little bit. Hug your inner elbows together. Push down through your feet, lift your heart, lean back, a little bit of a back bend. As you exhale, here we go, bring an inch forward. So you have to be careful not to lean back, but to keep your hips in line with your ankles. Placing your hands 10 to 12 inches in line with your shoulders. Push your palms down, straighten out your arms and your legs, extend the spine. Good, as you exhale, pull the floor back, bring your fingertips in line with the toes. And then reach the top of your head down toward the floor. So palms push down, your sit bones are lifting up. The palms pressing down, the sit bones are lifting up. Power through your legs, squeeze the muscles to the bones. Feeling the sit bones lifting and spreading apart. Hollow the belly out, get a little more in there. Push your hands down, lift your head and chest. Exhaling, replace the hands back underneath your shoulders. Bend your knees. Here we go, we're gonna jump our feet together. Okay, so your feet are together, your hands are still shoulder distance apart. Have your fingertips at the edge of your mat. So your fingertips are gonna be at the edge of your mat and the heels on the other edge of your mat. So, like this. Right? And then shift a little forward into that so you're lengthening your spine and you feel equal weight on your hands and your feet. From here, push down through everything that you have and get the palms down if you can. Bend your knees together if you need to. Right leg extends out to the side in line with your right hip and pull the heart forward. Inhale, exhale, one. Yes. Inhaling, exhale, two. Inhaling, exhale, three. Inhale, exhaling, four. Are you breathing? Inhale, exhale, right foot down. Here we go, left side. Push it down, left leg out to the side and extend your heart at the same time, one. Inhaling, exhaling, two. Inhaling, exhaling, three. Inhaling, exhaling, four. Inhaling, exhaling, left foot down. Don't get up yet, stay with your breath. Right hand, first two fingers in the thumbs, wrap around your right big toe. Don't think about it, just breathe. Here we go, push down through everything you have, take the right leg out to the side, extend your heart, one. Inhaling, I can see everybody. Two, don't leave me by myself. Three, inhaling, exhaling, four. Inhaling, exhaling, right foot down. Woo! Right hand goes down, right foot down, left hand. First two fingers in the thumbs, reaching for your big toe. Here we go. Push down, left leg extends out, inner thighs back and apart. Scoop your tailbone for your heart to move forward. Inhaling, exhaling, two. Inhaling, exhaling, three. I can see everybody. Four. Let's do it together. Four, five. Bring it down. Woo! That booty burn. And squat it down. I know. And you can have your feet together, open your knees out wide for malasana variation. And just bowing down in the center. Yeah. Whichever direction you're facing, it's all good for now. Just great. Okay, shift side to side. It's a nice little opener. All right, very slowly walk your hands back, Slide them back, keep the inner legs of your feet together, knees open wide. So by the feet pressing against one another, the knees extend out wide, shoulders over your hips. Good breath, prayer hands, heart center. Inhale, and as you exhale, there you go, push it and bring it up. To the balls of your feet, and heels down, arms. All right, hands onto your hips. Feet close together. Just finding the breath. Really finding the breath. Hands onto your hips. Squeeze your inner elbow points toward one another. And reach your right leg out about an inch off the floor. Point the foot, flex the foot. Point the foot, flex the foot. Point the foot, keep the foot pointing, and just flex your toes back. Keep that action, let the right foot step down. That will lift your left heel up. Chin parallel with the floor, throat back, ears back, palms down. Stay high up onto the balls of your feet, bending the knees, stop in line with your hips. Arms float up. Exhale, push it up. There you go. Inhale, feel the chest broad, stopping in line with your hips on your knees. Exhale up. There you go. Inhale, feel the chest broad, and exhale up. Two more. Squat, push down slowly as you bring it up. One more. Squat it down, shoulders over your hips, stay here, and then we're going to pulse. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Push down now, just the left heel down, right knee to your chest. Inhale, and as we exhale, hinge forward. Crossing at the wrist, hold on the opposite sides of your right foot. Inhale, and as you exhale, push the heel out of the way. Inhale, and as you exhale, chin to shin, hold one. Inhaling, exhaling, two. Inhale, exhaling, three. Inhaling, exhaling, four. Inhaling, exhaling, five. So inhale, lift up. Good. Left arm up alongside of your ear. Inhale, and as you exhale, the right leg goes open to the right. Don't forget me. Inhaling and exhaling. Good. Back to the center. Here we go. Arm out. Inhale, exhale, one. Inhale, exhale, two. It's just cool, isn't it? Inhale, exhale, three. Inhale, exhale, four. Inhaling, exhale, five. Inhale, right knee up. Exhale, right foot down. There could be way more to that, but I'm being really loving and nice today. All right. Feet close together. Hug your elbows in. So starting with the feet close together. Extend the left leg out about an inch off the floor so that you can point and flex. Point, flex, and point, and flex. Point the foot, keep it pointed, flex just the toes back. Squeeze your inner elbow points together, bring your chins up, throat back, step onto your left foot. Now your right heel lifts. Release your arms by the sides. If the lower ribs are jutting forward, pull them back. Here we go, squat it down, stop with your knees in line with the hips, palms float up. Exhale, pushing down. Inhale, broaden your chest, and exhale. Inhale, here we go, and exhale, two more. Come down, and exhale. One more, here we go, take it down, hold, and pulse. 8, go slow, 7. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Here we go. Straightening your legs. Right heel only goes down. Left knee up into your chest. Inhale. And as you exhale, hinge your hips, place your belly onto the thigh. Crossing at your wrist, hold on to opposite sides of the feet. Inhale. And as you exhale, push the leg out. Bring your chin to your shin. One. Inhale, exhaling,
Two. Inhaling. Exhaling. Three. Inhaling. Exhaling. Four. Inhaling. Exhaling. Five. So inhale, lift it up. Good. Right arm up alongside of your ear. Inhale, and as you exhale, open the left leg out to the side. Inhale, exhale, one. Inhaling, exhaling, two. Inhaling, exhaling, three. Inhaling, exhaling, four. Inhaling, exhaling, five. Inhale, leg back. We're all together here. Arms up, leg out. Inhale, exhale, one. Inhaling, exhale, two. Drive your right foot down, get out of your right hip, three. Inhaling, exhaling, four. Inhaling, exhaling, five. Inhale, left knee up. Exhale, left leg down. Right, top of the mat. Inhaling, arms up. Exhale, fold forward all the way down. Inhaling, half lift. Exhaling, chaturanga. That's your last chaturanga. And as you inhale into up dog, feel the openness of the pose. Exhaling, down dog. Just let your head hang down and breathe. Inhaling into plank. Exhaling slowly all the way through chaturanga to the floor. Lay on your belly, turn your head to the side and breathe. Just feel your belly pressing into the floor as you inhale and exhale. Let's breathe. Bringing your legs close together. Tops of your feet pressing down. Think about squeezing your inner ankle bones toward one another as your feet push evenly down into the floor. Arms alongside the body, palms facing up, the forehead down to the floor. So the arms up alongside the mat with the palms up. That's it. Forehead down, legs super engaged. Don't lift anything else, but just your shoulders 10 to 12 inches off the floor, your forehead down. Good, keep the back of your hands pushing into the floor, your shoulder blades lifting close to one another, and then now lift your head and chest, but keep your shoulder blades back. Now feel how the back of the hands push down, but get the shoulders up. Feel how the pelvis presses down. Press the shoulder blades into the back of your heart to move the heart forward. Engage your legs more, pushing down and reaching back so the low back is free. Inhale, exhale, release that down. Turn your head to the other side. Just breathe. Feel the low back softening here as you just rest. Beginning to zip your legs up again. Pushing your feet into the floor, squeezing your inner ankle bones into one another. Bring the forehead down to the floor. And this time, interlacing your hands behind your back. As you interlace your hands, palms together, really straightening out through your elbows. Stretch out through your elbows, reaching your hands back. So that already took your shoulder blades up like they were earlier, right? Be active in your legs, push down and lift your head and chest up. That's one half the pose. That's one half the pose. Your heart is moving forward. Now reach your legs back as your heart goes forward. Make it two parts of the pose. Push it down. Lift your legs up. Everything you can up. Make your heart go forward. Legs back. Take a deep inhale. Eyes look up between the third eye and exhale. Release it down. Whew. Rest. Feel the breath and how precious the breath is for you at this moment. Just let every inhalation come in and every exhale be complete. Just letting go. One more. Forehead to the floor. This time, bending your right knee, sweep your right arm back with your thumb face down. Grab onto your right ankle, top of the foot. Do the same with your left. Then bring your big toes to touch one another. Forehead down to start. Bring your shoulders 10 to 12 inches off the floor. Become alive in your toes. Do not let your knees go any wider than hip bone distance apart. From here, kick and lift. Kick and lift. That's it. Kick and lift. Don't let the knees sway. Hold here. Then kick your legs back. Kick your legs back. Yes, and lift it up. Knees come closer, knees come closer. Now, push your pelvis down. Scoop your tailbone. Draw your low belly in. And lift your heart up. Look up as you inhale. Beautiful. Exhale, release that down. Oh. Hands underneath your shoulders. Curl your toes. Push your seat to the heels. And rest in child pose. That should feel just absolutely luscious. Pressing your hands into the floor, gently round and roll up, sit back onto your heels for just a moment. Sitting up onto the top. Okay. I'm going to give you a headstand. You can do a headstand, just 10 breaths in a inversion. You don't even have to do the headstand. So, your choice. If you can get the hips higher than your heart, that's good. So, interlace your hands, palms together, elbows closer than shoulder distance apart. Then doing a down dog here. This could be enough for you for today. Walking your feet in towards your face. You're already in a great inversion. You could stay here. But if it's in your practice to do a full headstand, then put your head down, continue to walk your feet in until you feel the lift. Right? Wherever you need to be. And it's only 10 breaths. So find the sweetness in the pose. Find the ease and the sweetness in the pose. The press down to lift up the shoulders away from your ears. Finding your calm in the storm of this. Just breathe. Soften your eyes. Bring the awareness to the space between your eyebrows and just let yourself soften the upper pelvis. Now, when you feel complete with this, rest in child pose. Go any further, then feel free to pull back, go on as far as you'd like to go. If you have your own blocks, feel free to put 10 of them out there, hold them with your fingertips, and go down. Your choice. But find the breath, really connecting into your breath. Remember the exhalations. Just through your exhales, let yourself find the space. Keep sliding the shoulders away from your ears. Let go of that. Shift your jaw side to side. Make sure that you're not holding the tension or stress in your face. And holding onto your legs. Inhale, lift your head and chest. Exhale, sit back nice and easy. Bend the knees, feet onto the floor. Arms out, inhale, exhale, slow, 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 stop, push down, go up, nice and easy. Here we go, roll down, feel each vertebra, just feel it, one at a time. You have to round your back for this, really getting into the core. Hold,
by the push down, bring it up instead of a swing. The push it down, roots rising. That's it. Here we go. Haul it out. Here we go. Roll. And roll it out slow, slow. Hold it there. Breathe. It doesn't matter if you inhale or exhale. Go down halfway here. Got it? Hold it here. Hold. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Go down halfway, halfway, halfway. Hold. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And all the way down. Whoa. Hug it.
That was good.
I love it. Hug your knees into your chest. That's awesome. Again, we don't really have the props available, but we're moving for shoulder stand or happy baby pose. Take care of your necks, you can legs up the wall if that's available, wherever you'd like to go. I'm going to talk to you through a shoulder stand, but ignore me if you have your own thing going on. The knees to your chest, arms alongside of you. Inhale, and as you exhale, take the toes back behind your head. Once you get the toes to touch to the floor behind your head, take time to interlace your hands behind your back, straightening out from your elbows, shimmying your shoulders under. Once you get your elbows close to one another, release your hands, place your palms on your backs where your pinkies are parallel, and then by pushing through your elbows and shoulders, push down to lift your legs up. So ankles over knees, knees over hips, hips over the shoulders. There's a press down to lift up. Once the chest touches your chin, move your chin away, and that's pressing the occipital bones into the floor. So there's a push down and lift up. There's compression on your throat. Inhaling and exhaling, finding your breath. Inhaling and exhale. Bringing all of your awareness to your throat, where you say what you mean and mean what you say. Lining up what we say with what we do, right? Crossing the ankles if it becomes a while for you, to be harder to hold. If you can cross at your ankles and squeeze your upper thighs together, reach the soles of your feet toward the ceiling, and then bring your awareness to the space between your eyebrows, your intuition center, where you already know what to do, right? Just tap in and go inside instead of outside. Breathing in. Exhaling out, cross your ankles opposite if you've had them one way, cross the other to balance things out. Feel the press down to lift up, finding space. Your neck should actually not hurt at all. That little knobby part is not pushing into the floor because you've made a little tunnel in there. All right, then uncrossing at your ankles, drop the toes down behind your head, straight legs. And then if you can keep your big toes together on the floor, drop your knees by your ears and move yourself to squeeze. This is pratyahara. This is withdrawing of the senses. You're taking the hearing away. Simply feel your own heartbeat in there. And then inhale, and as you exhale, push your heels out, straightening the legs, extend the arms onto the floor, palms down on the mat. Gently begin to round and roll out one vertebra at a time, slowly coming out. Slow, 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 slow. When the feet get to the ceiling, you can bend your knees. Then as you extend your legs out, lay flat onto your back, you're going to lay onto straight arms. So underneath you are your arms are straight. Index finger and thumbs are close to one another. The palms are pressing down. The legs are reaching away from you. So just like you are with your cobra, hug your inner ankle bones toward one another. Reach your feet away, bend your elbows, and push down to lift your heart up. That's it. So legs straight. That's it. Roll your shoulder blades back, heart lift. That's the top of the head, barely pushing down. Your low back should feel free. So be really active in your legs. Reach them out of the way. Then lift up right through here. That's it. Take these steps. That's it. Barely push your head down. There you go. Make your low back open. Push down with everything you have, chin to your chest, inhale. Exhale, lay onto your backs, hug your knees into your chest. Hug yourself. Just hug. And breathe. Oh. Soles of the feet on onto the floor. Supine spinal twist. Cross your right knee over your left knee, crossing high up in the thigh. Extend your right arm out to the side, shoulder height or higher. Taking a deep inhale, and as you exhale, right knee going to the floor on your left side, but keep your right shoulder down. Your shoulder blade is your anchor. Sit. Gaze towards your right fingertips and breathe. Inhaling and exhaling here. Just notice in your physical body where you're feeling any resistance. What's keeping the shoulder blade from anchoring down to the floor and your knee touching the opposite side? Where would the resistance be in that? And then using your breath, breathe into that place of resistance as you inhale. And as you exhale, send away any tension or stress. Let each breath create space for you. Now, protecting your low back, draw your navel to the spine. Inhale, bring your knees and head back to the center. Uncrossing your legs, readjust your spine in neutral. Cross your left knee over the right knee, crossing high up in the thighs. The left arm extends out to the side, shoulder height. Take a deep inhale, and as you exhale, the left knee going to the floor on the right side. But let the left shoulder blade be your anchor. And just breathe into this. Inhaling and exhaling. Wherever the resistance is, wherever the tightness might be in your bodies, allow yourself to just be aware of that tightness and start to energetically direct your breath into that space. And as you exhale, see if you can let go a little bit of that holding on of the gripping. Also notice if it's different on one side compared to the other side, just noticing. Remember your breath and make space using the directed breath. All the hard work is over. It's done. Protecting your low back. Draw your navel into the spine. Inhale, bringing your knees and head back to the center. Uncrossing your legs. Readjust your spine in neutral. And then hug both knees up into your chest, neutralizing your spine here. Keep your tailbones down, push your shins straight down, your shoulders down, and that will open up your low back. And then pointing your toes, squeeze your knees to your forehead, squeeze yourself into the tightest little ball ever. Squeeze it, feel the compression on the throat. Take a deep inhale, and as you exhale, extend the legs out, arms out, turn your palms face up. So the feet just fall out to the sides, turn your palms facing up, shimmy your shoulders under. And allow the back of your head to press into the floor as you lay back. Today there will not be any adjustments in the practice, but I will walk you through the relaxation. So allowing your toes to soften and relax. As the toes soften and relax, feel the relaxation washing over you. From your toes into the feet. Just imagine laying maybe on the beach, just feeling the waves gently one after another. Feel the relaxation washing over you, just like that. Just really easy. Through your ankles, the shins, the calves, the knees. Allow all the joints in the body to soften and relax. The thighs, the hamstrings, the front of your hips, the sides of your hips, and even into the buttocks. Soften and let go. Allow your abdomen to become soft and the internal organs just melting back. You do nothing to hold yourself up now. Just let it go. From the belly soft into your chest being light, allow the breath to be whatever it needs to be. Feel your arms softening and relaxing. Begin to send your exhalations out through your fingertips one by one. With every exhalation, send away any worry, any tension, any stress. Just give each finger an exhalation and send your breath out. Feel your palms softening and relaxing. Through the arms, into the shoulders, through the neck, the throat, and your jaw. Let go. Allow your upper teeth to separate from your lower teeth and the tongue to simply float in the mouth. Every muscle in your face, soft. Letting go. Feel your eyes melting further back into their sockets. The space behind your forehead softening. Tips of your toes to the crown of the head, the entire being surrendering to the relaxation.
conscious breath back into your body. Just begin to deepen your respirations. Become aware of every inhalation and become aware of every exhalation. Allow every inhalation to rejuvenate. Allow every exhalation to cleanse. When you exhale, be sure that you're exhaling completely. As you continue to bring conscious breath back into the body, become aware of your physical body. Become aware of your toes and your fingers. It may feel good to stretch your arms up over your head, stretching out through your legs. Take a deep body stretch, stretching the right side a little more than the left side a little more than the right, and then stretching it out nice and even. Bending the knees, soles of the feet onto the floor, very gently curling over to your right side, and let yourself stay on your side. So the right arm could be like a pillow for you for a moment. And just taking a moment to notice if you are able to relax or not, knowing that it's always there for you just a few breaths away. Don't come up yet, but when you do come up, we'll be moving into a short meditation. So when you're ready, turn toward the floor, press yourself up into a seated position, pick a seat, pick it wisely, and then be still. So if you need the support of a wall, feel free to move up toward a wall, but sit nice and tall. Feel your sit bones grounding, feel the extension in the spine and all the space in between. And then bring all of your awareness to the breath, every inhalation and every exhalation. On every inhalation, silently suggest let. On every exhalation, silently suggest go. Inhaling, let. Exhaling, go. Let. Go. into your heart center, just a moment of reflection upon our own lives and all the blessings in our lives. Acknowledging that light that shines within your own heart and allowing your light to shine brightly. We look for light in all beings, and today we see each other's light and we bow to each other's light with namaste. Thank you all so much for being here today. Things are kind of different, and we're not really sure what to expect as far as like things shutting down, but as far as